Hello everybody, looks like it works now, so sorry for this being late a bit, so some technical problems. However, I have a very good mood today because early in the morning I had my second, actually in my life, exam in my language school here in Germany, so my German becomes better and better from day after day. So let's see how this affects my chess. Let's get to Blitz and play some interesting games. Just like during previous Banter Blitz show, I started with some training against Kasper. However, Kasper played Nh3 and I just decided to abort the game because it's not interesting. I guess you guys will play just more solid openings. Okay, so let's see. I already have some challenges. Let's see. Okay, there are a lot of actually. Well, so let's play against Mikhail Tal. 5 minutes, so normal time control. So I just accept it. And here we go. D4, yeah, much better than Nh3 at least. Okay. Knight goes to f6. And bishop goes to g5. Interesting. Okay. Let us ask this bishop why it came to g5. Just to put the bishop on h4. Okay. So probably white wants me to play d5 and to play something very classical, like Queen's Gambit or something. Okay. I'm not against. So let's see how it works. Queen's Gambit, by the way, was the opening, Queen's Gambit declined, was the opening of my childhood. But then I started playing something else. Okay, knight c3, bishop goes to e7. I have to continue my development. h3. Well, that is something new to me, at least. Interesting. Maybe g4 will be the next move. Maybe not. Okay, I will castle just to see what will happen. E3. Okay. So now again, my main task is to continue development. My bishop on c8 is awful. So what about improving its position? Bishop to g3. Well, okay. Bishop to b7, knight to f3, well, looks like a typical development, but white spent the time on h3 in the opening. But position is closed, maybe it's not so bad. But I will try to be aggressive a bit. So c5. Sooner or later, I would have made this move anyway. So why not right now, when I have some sort of upper hand in development? Bishop goes to e2. Well, what about this? Something concrete starts in the center. Okay, it takes with the knight. But now I think I can take on c4. Or not. Well, I can, of course, but I'm not sure if it gives me anything. So after d5 takes c4, he castles. And g2 is protected, c4 is hanging. But let's try. Okay. Castle, so now pawn on c4 is hanging, and it's not so easy for me to protect it normally. So bishop d5 is possible, of course. Should I do that or not? Well, not that sure. Okay. Let's forget about material and trying to improve our position. So now I can grab some space on the queen side, which is important. Okay, logical. Everything looks very typical. So how to complete my development? With the knight on d7 or knight on c6? After knight c6, I guess bishop f3 will be not that pleasant to meet. So I will put my knight here. I have some prospects here, so knight goes to b6 and probably occupies c4. Okay, bishop goes to f3, I think I have to capture it. Knight takes, okay, I expected queen takes f3, but well, it's also possible. So that's occupy a bit vulnerable point. On c4, activate the knight and attack at least a pawn at the moment. Queen takes, okay. I guess with the rook will be the most natural reply. Okay, b4, weakens a3, and my knight is already on c4, so that might be dangerous a bit. Might be not. Okay, I will try this move. An interesting one. Just activating the rook, maybe intending to double rooks over d-file, and also attacking a3 pawn, which now I can capture. Why not? Okay. One extra pawn. Knight goes to d4, looks like I can take on b4. Two extra pawns. Knight to c6. Okay, let's go back. Most solid position for the bishop. Knight goes to d4. Okay, my knight on a3 is placed not very well. However, it protects b5 pawn, so I can push my a pawn, right? So why not to do that? My general plan now is just to push my pawns, to queen them. Probably both, if I can. Okay. Let us continue the movement. It looks fine. But I should be careful with the time, I guess. But my plan is pretty clear, so I guess I can make moves quite quickly. So my knight on a3 is protected by the bishop from f8. That's why I don't have to spend the time on, for example, moving my knight away. So now my strategy is just to play b2 and then b1. And at the moment, I can't see normal defense. Bishop e5. Okay, this doesn't change anything, I think. So b2. Rook takes. Well, queen with check. And now I can take the rook. Well, decisive advantage. Yeah. Okay. Not that bad for the start. Let's go further. So, other challenges. Let's see. So, 5 minutes. Okay. During previous show, I played 1 3-minute game, but wasn't that successful, so probably I will play 1 3-minute game later today, probably not. Let us see. So, okay, one more 5 minutes. And I'm playing with white, right? Okay, let's start with open games. C5 Sicilian, okay, that should be fun. I never had boring games in Sicilian, actually. Okay, a6, let's try this Bobby Fischer move, bishop to c4. Well, you ask, so we only challenge 5 minutes. You can challenge me 3 minutes as well, but well, I prefer to play 5 minutes. However, it doesn't mean that I will ignore all 3 minutes challenges. Okay, let's go away with the bishop, because it's hanging. So I want to castle and then to start the attack as soon as possible. But everything depends on what black will do. Knight to c6, okay. Castles, because my knight on d4 is protected. Bishop goes to e7. Now I think prior to playing f4, I have to protect my knight on d4, so I'll play bishop to e3. Castles. And in this position, I usually prefer not to hurry up, actually, so I make this move. So king goes to h1, very useful prophylaxis, because the king, after white plays f4, may be attacked along this diagonal a7, g1. So it's usually a good idea to just to go to the corner. Here the king is quite safe, and I don't have to worry about these checks. Okay. If my opponent follows the chat, actually, he can pick up some useful information about what to do in this position. Well, actually, against knight b4, I wanted to play bishop to b3, and my bishop is okay. So e5. Well, this actually weakens d5 point. However, he wants to play bishop e6 next. What about just knight to f5? Bishop takes, knight b4, bishop goes away, then d5 probably, or rook d8, preparing well, not that easy to estimate. Knight goes to e2, then knight to g4, then knight to d5, actually. So, well, after knight to e2, probably just bishop to e6. Yeah, not so clear. Okay, I will try to do something counterintuitive, so I just improve black's position in the center. However, I think I have a chance to undermine it immediately or not. So let's see how it works. Now my mood gets worse, because I understood that, well, knight c6 was just a bad decision. Come on. But okay, it's Blitz after all, so even if you don't achieve what you want, well, you have a chance to be quick, to be aggressive, and to be better at tactics and something like that. Okay, b2 is handy, so bishop b3 is just in the air. But first I want to open up the f file, which is, I guess, very important, because I have a bishop on this long diagonal, right? So I want to come up with the attack using that bishop, and opening the f file is just a good idea, I guess. Well, activating this light squared bishop is a basic idea for this line, the whole line. So if black's pawn remains on e6, white usually tries to play f4, f5, just to force black to play e5 and to open up that diagonal. Okay, bishop g4, well, attacking my queen. But looks like I wanted to get to the king side, so I will do this typical move. I want my queen on g3, I think, or on h4, so it depends. Probably on g3. Okay, so bishop on b4. What about just taking on f6 here and then queen g3? Attacking the bishop and then winning that bishop with the help of h3 move. Looks quite promising, no? Or queen g3 first with the threat of rook takes f6. And if, for example, queen d7, then h3 attacking that bishop. And when bishop goes away, then rook takes f6, right? Okay. So both options are possible, I think. Which is better? Okay, let's calculate. Queen goes to g3, h5, rook takes f6, takes, and h3. Or queen g3, h5, h3. And now he has something like bishop takes c3 and knight e4 intermediate. Okay, I will take on f6 immediately. Typical sacrifice, but here it is even not a sacrifice, I guess. Because I win this bishop g4 back. Or should I play queen h4? Attacking the bishop intending to take on f6 with the bishop h6 idea. Well, that is not that clear, so I will do this. Because at least I win some material here. Queen to c8, okay. Let's attack this guy. Did I miss something? I guess no. Okay, I'll take it. Queen takes. So should I trade the queens or not? I guess, yeah, that's fine. I have a pair of bishops. So two minor pieces are usually better than the rook. And my opponent has some weaknesses on the f-file, as well as on the queen side, a6, c6. So I have some concrete objects of attack. Yeah, I guess I'm better. King g7, okay. Rook to g8. Well, let's start fixing opponent's weaknesses. a6 is fixed. So sooner or later, I will try to attack it with the bishop, maybe. Midnight here in India. I have to sleep soon. Hope to get a game before that. Okay, I will try. Okay, king goes to f8. g4 is protected. So what to do in this position? Maybe bishop to b6 just to control d8 square and to grab the d-file. Additional idea behind playing a5. By the way. Whoa! 42 seconds, but my opponent has not much as well, so I have good chances, I guess. Okay, let's attack something. Time is melting. Okay. I could have taken the bishop, but knight c7 is also good. Okay, great. So, very fond Sicilian. Bishop b4 was decisive mistake, I guess. Because, well, after that I just have rook f6, queen g3, winning material. Even earlier, black could have played better. So instead of allowing me to take on the e5, I think it was much better to play knight g4, attacking my bishop, and then to take on f4 and to put the knight in the center on the e5 square. Quite a typical idea for black in this pawn structure. Okay, so who's gonna sleep in a few minutes? So, okay. Did you have a challenge, my friend? There is that. Chess chip. Where is chess chip? Come on. Interesting. I can't find it. Uh-huh. I found it. Great. Accept. So again, I'm with black. D4, again closed. Come on, guys. Well, I'm not against, but Is anybody going to play e4 against me today? A3, okay. Kasparov Petrosian system. Well, I don't have a chance to occupy b4 anymore, so let's get to g7. Maybe a bit surprising, maybe not, who knows. Okay, g3. Not quite sure how to continue here. So basically, it is usually just to double those pawns to take on f3, but here we have a bit different situation. But okay, I will take that. So now, continue development. A bit risky opening setup, by the way. Yes, I like double fink at two line. Bishop to g2. Okay, so let's castle. And d5. So, as we can see, after pawn went to f3, d4 is a bit vulnerable, so I'm trying to fix it. And then maybe in the future to come up with some attack against that pawn. Maybe I can even get this typical play against isolated pawn. Maybe not. I'm not sure. Everything depends on my pawn choice now. Bishop to g5. Well, this gives me a chance to play h6, maybe. But I guess I will have some problems with the d5 pawn. So maybe it makes sense just to protect it first with the c6. So now, whenever white takes on d5, I will recapture with the c6 pawn. It is much better than taking with the e pawn, because now c file is open and I don't have a weakened pawn on the c file, so I have very solid pawn structure now. Okay, rook to c1. What about this bishop first? Maybe it wasn't necessary. Is it normal to give up the queenside b7 bishop? In this concrete setup, yes. But actually, it happens when white plays queen c2 instead of g3. So black takes on f3, probably forcing g2 takes f3. A bit different position arises. But yes, it is a surprising but quite typical for this opening line. Bishop goes to e3. Okay, if knight goes to c6, then probably knight takes d5, queen takes d5, and f4, taking my knight, so I have to prepare that. I guess it's a good idea for me to play queen d7, because I want my knight on c6, not on d7 here, because on d7 there is nothing to do. d4 just controls e5, c5 square, so my knight will remain very passive. h6 is Henning. I don't like the idea of playing h5 here, because it weakens a lot my kingside. At least at the moment I don't want to do that, so I will protect my h6 with the help of king h7. So white has a pair of bishops, right? But position is quite closed, especially dark squared bishop looks very passive, but bishop on g2 as well, so it is not that great at the moment. Okay, now it's time to complete a development. Okay, smart. Bishop goes to b5 or a6, depends. So I guess I have the time for this move, knight to a5. So now I have two ideas. The one is tactical, to put the knight on b3, another is positional, to put it on c4. And looks like I can do that right now. Yes, I will put my knight on c4. It looks so natural. So instead of queen c2, bishop b5 was an interesting idea, an intermediate attack of my queen, but then queen, for example, goes to, well, even to b7. Knight b3 was still a threat. Wow, so I can't take on a3 or what? My knight is trapped there. Come on. Yeah, that is not that great, but I have another good route for this horse. So first on d6 and then hopefully to f5, attack on d4. Maybe not in the nearest future, but it is quite a typical square for the knight in such a situation. At the same time, from d6, my knight prevents bishop b5, knight b5, and this activity. Okay, what about the c file? I guess it is worth of my attention, at least. Queen d2, queen goes back. h6 is under pressure. So what should I do here? Not so easy to come up with the concrete plan. Maybe to play b5 just to limit the activity of the bishop even more. But this weakens c5. And I'm not that sure if it is good. But the knight won't have that easy route to c5 anyway, but the rook will have. Well, so it is a double-edged position after b5. Don't like it very much. But I don't have the time. So I should play fast. That's why b5. Idea here is to limit the bishop first. Another idea is to limit a bit pawn on a3, which is a bit vulnerable, and it is my potential object of attack. Okay, 92. This guy is very smart. So now I have to be quick. I don't want a queen on a5, so I play a5 myself. Okay. He occupies the file. So he's a chess player from India. Very smart one. But b4, come on. Is it really possible? I don't think so. Okay. Well, now I have very good pawn structure. And also this great spot for my knight. And also an extra pawn. Okay, let's simplify the situation a bit. Should be quick, so. Yep. Okay. Not that against that. Okay, g5. h5. h4. Limiting. Okay. Takes. What a mess. Okay, that was an interesting game, by the way, very tough, but I guess your mistake was to allow me to get to c4. Probably you thought that you can take on c4 twice using the pin, but in fact, after rook takes c4, I can't take with the pawn because my queen on b7 is hanging, but I have intermediate queen takes f3 attacking your knight on e2 and rook on c4 at the same time, and a3 is hanging, so I will have I would have had a great position in that case. Okay. Opening fanatic. So opening fanatic wants to play. Opening fanatic. Opening fanatic. No, rook takes c4 is not possible. Queen takes f3 and black has very good position. Okay. One more black game. Okay, opening fanatic, please play something not closed. Can I ask you about that or not? Great, thank you very much. Scotch. Well, that's interesting. That should be interesting at least. Okay, bishop c4. Well, a tricky line. Okay. I usually play this. e5 and counterattack with the d5. And after bishop b5, I almost never play knight to e4. I play here on d7. Which looks strange, however, there is one deep strategic idea behind this move. And if compared to knight e4, black usually has to learn less theory. Well, bishop takes on c6, yes. Pawn takes on c6, and queen takes on d4. So knight takes d4 could be met with knight to b8. Controlling everything, but having everything in almost initial positions, right? But believe me, it is a promising line for black. Okay, after queen d4, I have a chance to attack this queen immediately with the help of bishop c5, but after that queen goes to g4, where he wants to be, so that will be a help, probably. So instead of doing that, I will try... I will try what? I will try knight to c5. So now I have a pair of bishops. Well, actually it is better to study chess using both. Digital board in ChessBase, for example, and of course a real board for everything else. Castles, yeah, I can continue my development now. Time to castle. Come on. Father is calling, but I'm busy. Sorry for that, forgot to mute my telephone. Opening fanatic thinks. Pawn goes to c3. Well, quite an accurate move at first glance, but this weakens d3, so why not to try to exploit that and at the same time to complete a development? Looks just fine. This looks dubious to me. So now I can play knight d3 followed by bishop c5. And where this queen moves? To a4 probably. Well, it's not trapped immediately. Maybe knight to e6 instead. But the same, so queen has a4 square, unfortunately. But anyway, knight e3 looks very natural idea, so let's do that. Mobile phone? No, of course it is not a forfeit. Not today, at least. This game is not federated, so I guess my opponent will understand that life happens. Okay, rook to f1. Bishop c5, queen to a4. c5, the same. Only one square, by the way, for a queen after bishop c5. Well, queen h4 is actually another one. Well, what to do instead? So c5, probably queen goes to e3. Don't know what would be better, but let's try to surprise my opponent after quite a long thinking process. Queen b8. Attacking b2, I'm probably intending to play queen b6 at a proper moment. Let's say after bishop c5. Attacking f2. Some sort of Rubinstein maneuver. Lord e24, where are you from? If you ask me, that originally I'm from Ukraine, but currently I live in Germany. Wants me to take on h4 and to give up my dark squared bishop, the bishop that I really love. But what about bishop c5 instead? Queen to a4, and then I can move my bishop from f5 somewhere. Well, it starts looking a bit ugly actually. About c5 instead, queen goes to a4 as well, but I will still attack his knight on h4. Okay, let's do that. So if queen takes on d5, I have bishop takes h4. Queen has only one square, I guess, on a4. Yes, and now I can move my bishop away. Let's say on e6, protecting everything. And pawn on b2 is still hanging, by the way. No, I don't have my own chess 24 mark. But I have very cool Master Yoda mark. So, I love it. Okay, this looks like a mistake. c4, knight goes to f3. Well, I will capture that. Oh, he wants to flag me, I think. Because I have only 30 seconds, so I have to be really quick here. But I have an extra minor piece, and my position looks very solid at the moment, so I guess I will have good chances to do that. I mean, to win. So, what's next? Okay, he wants what he wants of me. Time. Yes, I agree. Time is melting. So let's simplify. Okay. Nope. Doesn't want that. God. Wow. I have a chance. I won on time? What happened? I lost on time. God. But that was a... Yeah. I just talked a lot during this game. Come on. Or I won. I don't understand. Yes, I won. Okay, thank you very much. I won it. So my mood just gets much better after that. At least I deserve this win because I was playing better. I won the minor piece, so the only problem was the time management. But thanks God, probably, or thanks Master Yoda, I just managed to win it. Finally. Okay, so next challenge. Well, somebody says that white won, but no. As you can see, well, probably you can't see that, but my opponent has 0 and I have 1. So I won. Okay, let's go further. Maybe it's time to play somebody rated a bit more than 2,000 points. What about this guy with 2,386 rating? 5 minutes? So, okay, let's accept that. Sicilian, okay. So here I have to be more careful with my time because this time problem arises in every game and causes some troubles. Okay, b5 immediately. I don't like to think it's so early stage. What does it mean? I have to learn openings. Okay, let's play something stupid. Pawn pusher. If you left a challenge, yes, probably I got it. H6, okay. I have to go back. I achieved absolutely nothing. Because probably A3 is a wrong move. But G6. Well. Okay. undermining b5 pawn. Quite a typical idea here. But maybe it is not correct in this particular position. I don't know. What is that? I just don't understand. What is going on? Okay, I can take that pawn. Now I have an extra pawn. Bishop e7. Okay, let's castle. I have an extra pawn and all the pieces developed. h6 is hanging. I will capture that with pleasure. So two extra pawns now. Come on, what is going on? What is going on? Queen b6 is coming. Like Winter in Game of Thrones. Okay, I'll just come back to prevent that queen b6. Bishop to f8. Oh god. What to do in a winning position? To win it. You have to win it, Andrey. Lower LO, no play? Of course not. I play to lower rated players. Let's exchange and come up with the h5. It is just not so easy to play to everybody because I have a limited time. So b2 is hanging, right? Okay, I will protect it. So it's time to occupy this square, I think. Queen to c8. c2 is hanging. Okay. Let's protect it. Knight to c5. What is that? That is an attack of my e4 pawn, but I can just take on f6 probably. Yes, I will do that. After all, I have two extra pawns, so all these simplifications should be beneficial. Okay, what about this check now? Two extra pawns, better pieces, so if nothing surprising happens, I should win. But again, should be careful with the time. Okay, I think I have this interesting possibility. Forcing the queen to e6 because my threat was to do this with a checkmate. Okay. So, who's next? Who is complaining about not playing? Okay. So, one more 2,300 player. Let's play closed. So, I'm a bit bored of playing only opened. positions. So let's play closed. Okay, d6. You want to play e5, I think, so I'll prevent that. Well, your knight will go to a5 sooner or later. I didn't like this variation because I don't know it. I almost never play this closed position in my real tournament practice, so. I will probably achieve nothing. Out of the opening, but okay, let's see how it goes. Because chess is not only opening stage after all. So, of course, if I don't blunder anything already, I can take with the queen even if I want. But I will take with the bishop. C6. Now d6 is vulnerable a bit. Which is not bad, I guess. However, d5 is common. And if I play knight to c3, then probably even c5, maybe, no? Okay, I will try knight c3. Queen to c7. And now what? Let's say h3. Bishop goes to e6, now d5 is in the air, so rook to c1 to prevent that stuff. Preparation. Okay, let's grab some space and achieve some sort of Marozzi bind pawn structure. But with the bishop on g2 instead of, let's say, e2 and so on. B5 is a real threat or not? I think no. Again, 1 minute against 2 minutes. Time management. Time management is my problem. This chat doesn't work. Which chat, guys? I can see all your comments. Queen to e7. Okay. Well, bishop b6 was probably better. I missed that. Space. I want the space. Queen in the center. What to do next? Not quite sure. I'm not a big master of playing super quick chess, so should be careful with that during next game. I mean, with the time. Okay, space, space, space. A lot of space. I have a lot of space. Well, should it be winning or not? Probably not. Probably yes. Yes, again, this time. Okay, I have to make a break, I guess. But anyway, a good game. A good game. So it was not so easy to break through. But I managed to outplay my player in the very end, probably. But again, not so much time left. And I didn't manage to checkmate in time. Okay, so let's have a look on other challenges. So pawn pusher, okay. He wanted to play me, so let's play. French defense, okay. I'm not against French defense. Bishop b4. Something new if compared to previous show. So during previous show, my opponents played something like knight f6, or I don't even remember what was that. Okay, a4, not the main line, but also quite poisonous continuation. Yes, chat is lagging, that's true. Bishop to d7, bishop to b5. It usually goes here to provoke a6. Okay, I'm ready to castle. And he castles long. Well, quite a typical play for this variation. So I have a pair of bishops, so probably I have to open up a position completely if I can. Can I? Probably not immediately. So I will do some prophylaxis first. Prophylaxis. So g file is open. My g2 pawn was probably a potential weakness, or at least a target for black's pieces. So now my pawn is on g3 and feels a bit better, I guess. h5 with the idea of h4, so I will put my knight there to prevent that, probably. Well, not probably, I actually do this. I mean, probably it helps me with this plan. So queen here. What about h5 pawn? Can I take it? Can I take it or not? Bishop f4 is also tempting, but then a5. Black is in time to prevent all that. And d4 is hanging, actually. Maybe just to take that c5. first it looks like an anti-positional decision, but in fact I have pair of bishops, so the more open position becomes, the better for me, the more chances I have. I mean, okay, knight to e5, now c5 is heading. But I guess I have this interesting move, pinning the knight. So I'm not against, for example, bishop to b5, because in that case a file becomes open. That is fine. So black should find something else. But it is not that easy. Maybe. Okay, if I take on d7, what will my opponent do? Or maybe it's just better to play something like queen e2, attack an e5 knight. Yep, I will try that. So now I have an extra pawn, but that is not a healthy pawn. Okay, so let's take here first. G3 is protected, that's important. So I can just take on e5. Maybe it was better to take on d7 first. Don't really know. In both cases, I think I have a promising position. So I have extra material, I have some sort of typical blockade in the center, pawn h5 looks vulnerable, pawn e6 as well, and I managed to prevent the most dangerous, I guess, I managed to prevent the attack. Okay, let's take that. E6 is now hanging twice. So probably rook h6 is more or less forced. Otherwise, I will take on e6 with pleasure, increasing my material advantage. Yes, now I can see this, that something really wrong happens to the chat, because some comments appear that were put just 15 minutes ago, 17 minutes ago, but okay. I'm not a technician, I can't fix it. So rook h7, can I take on e6 simply, or what to do? Or is it better just to increase the pressure with the help of c4 move? I guess, yeah. It deserves attention. So the point here that if pawn takes, I take the queen, if queen takes, I take on a7. Continuing with the attack, I think. Very annoying one. Yeah, I can take that. Rook a8 is in the air. Queen h4 is possible using the pin of g3, but then rook a8 and take g8. And after knight takes, I take the queen. So this doesn't work. Otherwise, it's very hard to find a good defense. King d7. Well, I have plenty of different options here, but I will just take on b7. And now I will just take on e6. Okay. Thank you very much for this game. Let's see other possibilities to play today. Okay, interesting. 2410. Accept. And I play with black. E4, E5. Let's continue with this classic move. My favorite one. Very solid one. And Ruy Lopez. Classics, classics, classics. Okay. I'm very glad to face exactly this opening. C3. Bishop goes to D7. Protecting the knight, preventing damage in the pawn structure, and at the same time occupying quite typical position. So now I will try G6. D4. Well, I guess it's time to play B5. And to put the bishop on the natural square on g7. Why I played b5 first? Just because I didn't want to exchange my light squared bishops after to exchange light squared bishops after this d4 d5. Exactly. Because in that case, I will be with bad minor pieces. A4. Okay. First, I have to complete my development, and under that. Only then to think of something else. Okay, what could be a plan here? C6 looks natural. And to take with the bishop, protecting everything and also counterattacking. So e4 is under attack. Okay. What is next? Have a weakened pawn on d6. But with the knight on a3, it doesn't seem to be the biggest problem. So let's try this move. Very concrete one. Just attacking a4. If pawn takes on b5, well, a file becomes open and probably my rook starts exerting some pressure. Bishop to g5. Okay, he probably wants to take my knight on f6, and maybe I'm not that against that. Okay. Let's see what will happen. Yes, he takes. Now h6 is hanging, so I have probably to go back. Now I have a pair of bishops, but my bishop on g7 is imprisoned, so I have to do something to activate it in the future. So my bishop on g7 is probably misplaced. His knight on a3 is misplaced as well. Okay, b5 is now hanging. No, it doesn't hang. No? Is it hanging or not? Not, of course. Getting tired, sorry. So, to take on a4, this will give his knight a square on c4, so I will keep this pawn, at least for this moment. So, I will play this. Just improving a bit position of the queen, because on the d file it wasn't that suitable and pleasant. Okay, so now I can play b4 if I want, but I don't want. Otherwise, his knight goes through c2 to b4. Also, not that great. also not that great, but okay, let's see. I'll just protect my b5 pawn, and now I want to come up with a counterattack as soon as possible. Yes, I wanted to do this. Because it looks like I'm prepared just fine for this activity. And I have pair of bishops, so I have to open up a position. Interesting idea, just keeping everything protected, and this just doesn't give my knight a chance to get to f4 through d5, and knight b4 is the next move. So, okay, let's see what happens if I do this. Maybe knight d5 now? Yeah, why not? But then g3 probably. Not so easy to estimate that position, but okay. g3 is a concession at least. Maybe I can even play f5 after g3, maybe not. Not so easy to estimate everything. Just a healthy central move, preventing knight b4 and creating a threat. Increased threat of knight f4. Okay, so what about this regrouping, protecting e5, it is a very important pawn. So now I definitely want to play f5 at some point. Interesting. So now my bishop on g7 is not that bad, because sooner or later I will play f5, e4, and activate it. My opponent is an anti-cheat moderator, by the way. Okay. Well, I will take it. Can't see any reason to worry about that. Okay, to simplify or not? That's an interesting question, but okay. Let's take. Knight on e7 is a threat, so let us put my rook here. Okay, for the first time, I have an advantage in time on the clock. Okay, let's protect everything. That was probably a mistake. God. Oh my God. Yeah, I won on time. Actually, in the end, I played like a moron. Sorry for that. Probably I'm just getting tired. So maybe one or two games and we will finish. So one more. Very interesting. Yeah, my website works too slow. I guess it is kind of general problem today for chess24. Not sure exactly, but well, when there is a problem with chat, when there is a problem with loading the game and so on, it can't be a coincidence, right? Very strange. I accepted another challenge, but it just doesn't work. Okay, I will try to refresh my page. Maybe this helps. Okay, finally. E4, E5, so probably I will play Ruy Lopez myself now. Okay, knight f6, d3, bishop c5 takes on c6, very popular line nowadays. This kind of exchanged variation. But, so the same pawn structure but appears from Berlin, from knight f6. But ideas are pretty similar. Okay, what about attacking this pawn on e5? Exactly. I don't remember the theory here, but maybe there is no theory at all. Bishop on d6, now what? Probably bishop g5 trying to provoke some weaknesses. On the king's side, and now bishop goes to d2 to have e3 square for the knight. Okay, thank you guys for doing your best to make it work properly again. I mean the chat. Okay, knight c5. So that's clear, the knight goes to e6 maybe, but my knight also wants to obtain a good square. Maybe on f5, why not? Maybe all that was just premature, I don't know. So now the knight controls very important squares, f4, d4. Does it make sense to limit the knight with the g3 move? Maybe yes, because knight f4 looks annoying a bit. So I will do that here. Yeah. I'll play g3. However, it weakens light squares, so I should be very careful. c5, yeah. Logical continuation to knight d4 is a threat, probably, already. Well, it looks not great at all. So I wanted to achieve a different position, but I achieved this. I should work with my opening knowledge, I guess. I'm not satisfied with the results of the openings today. Let's just castle. Continue development, and now c4 is an interesting spot for my knight, so I will go there. Yeah, very easy move to make. I'm not sure that I have anything at all, but at least bishop on d6 looks very passive. So if he takes on c4, maybe it will be not that bad for me. So yeah, now I have better minor pieces at least. So what to do with the active rook? To exchange it? Maybe a bit later, maybe now, because you never know what will happen next. Okay, my rook is hanging, I have to protect it. Yeah, boring position. Boring position. What to do? That is what happens when you don't know the opening. And play Banter Blitz when you don't have enough concentration. So you don't have enough resources, mental resources, to obtain a better position. Because you know what? Even if you don't know the opening line, if you think properly, you can find best moves. But when it's Blitz, believe me, it's very hard to do. Okay. That's probably what I wanted. And probably this as well. Okay. Now I start being happy with my position. But maybe I still don't have anything concrete. At least I can create some threats. Okay, he wants to exchange everything. Let's try to improve a pawn structure at least. So if rook takes, pawn takes, and my pawns become a bit better, but rook b3 is not possible because of queen takes a8. So that is definitely not a move. Okay, what's next? Knight to h4 leads to simple g6. So maybe I will start with just h4, h5, limiting a bit Black's position. Well, this is interesting. This leads to a very promising pawn structure. Okay, so now my knight can go to c4, and my king, by the way, can go there as well. So let's centralize the king first, and then we'll see who would be better on c4. Maybe nobody. Not so easy. So if knight c4, knight takes b3, so okay. Let's come up with another plan. I can also attack c5 somehow. So if c takes d5, e takes d5, he can play f5 maybe. Might be not that pleasant, so I'll make a prophylactic move. And now, yes, I have this interesting square on e4 for my knight. So, yeah. Now I definitely like my position. f5, is it this threat? Okay, g6 is an idea, I guess. With the f5 threat next. Can I prevent it? Well, not really. Not really. Well, okay. I have to be quick. Okay, this leads to isolated pawn. That is great. Can I capture the pawn? Not sure. Closer to the center. Now I can't capture the pawn. 100%. Okay, so probably one more game and it will be the last for today, because as you can see, the quality of my chess gets worse and worse game after after another, because, well, I'm just tired a bit. So, looks like chat works again, no? Yes, looks like they fixed this problem, so okay. Let's play the last game of today's Banter Blitz. I hope it was better than my previous Banter Blitz show. So let's finish with the 2454 player. At least it will be interesting. But I may lose because I'm tired and started playing quite badly. Let's see. Anyway, Sicilian. Okay. Sicilian means Sicilian. Very interesting play. It's guaranteed. Also one popular variation. Nowadays, many players play that. Many good players play that. But I'm not sure how to react here. So h4 is probably a nasty threat. So if I play h4 myself, g4 square becomes vulnerable, so he can use it. So probably it's better for me just to play this h3. At least controlling g4. Okay, now I have to go here. Strange square for a queen. Oh yeah, probably instead of h3, f4 was an interesting try. Actually, giving my opponent a chance to grab my dark squared bishop, but on the other hand, getting some tempi and starting the attack in the center. And now my queen is just misplaced. Looks ugly. But maybe I will be faster in the attack. Who knows? Nobody knows. So if knight jumps to c4, I will probably just grab it immediately, and then maybe something active, maybe e5, but well, looks dubious from a positional point of view, but maybe correct from this dynamic point of view. Okay, knight goes to c6. That is interesting. So I didn't expect that move. Can I play just f5 here? That will close a position completely, so not so interesting. And what about completing a development? How to do that correctly? Maybe just bishop e2 and then bishop to f3. Exerting some pressure in that diagonal. Isn't it slow? Looks like that. Yeah, but I will try. Because my opponent wants to play b5, right? So this idea at least stops this plan or makes it not so easy to perform. Yeah, very strange position. At first glance, it looks like this typical Scandinavian or something like that, or classical Sicilian, but this queen on h2, and the pawn is already on h4, makes a difference. Seems we are back with our fingers on the keyboards. Yeah, seems like that. But too late. I'm about to finish. Ha ha ha. Next time, guys. I think next time will be even better than this one. So, b5, eventually. Should I play something like that? Looks very promising. Looks very promising. At least my opponent thinks a lot. That is also a kind of achievement, right? So it takes on d4. Maybe to take with the rook to prevent b4. I don't know. Is it a good idea? Interesting one, at least. Okay, e5 is kind of vulnerable. Actually, I can prevent everything by playing rook to d1, because on e5, then capturing e5 will be wrong in the view of rook d8, but rook d1 leads to bishop c5, so it looks ugly. Yeah, maybe this rook d4 was a mistake. Don't really like my position now. Let's make at least an active move. So, bishop on c5 looks a nasty threat. God. But then just rook to d3 after all, or rook to e4. I know, everything looks very dubious. Well, yeah. Okay, maybe just to protect the pawn. Come on, I can't see anything there. And I have only 1 minute, so I have to hurry up. Knight to c5. Okay, can I just play? What I want to play? So he wants definitely to play b4 and then to capture on e4. But can I play rook to d1 here and then rook d8? It's kind of threat, but my queen is misplaced, so it takes so long time. Okay, I'll prevent b4 probably. Knight d5 is crushing here. Yes, you might be right. But I can't see that because I'm tired, but now it should work, right? No, knight b3, come on. So I should make one more prophylactic move. And now it could be the case. Okay, now it should work. Thanks for advice. Yeah, but I managed to spoil even this. Okay, so it looks like it's time to finish because my play became really bad during last, I don't know, 15 or 20 minutes. So I'm really tired. Thank you very much for being with me today. I hope next Banter Blitz will be much better than this one and we won't have these technical problems and everything will be just fine. For those who follow my show on Tuesdays, you're welcome next week, same time, 7 p.m. by European time zone. And next week, I'm not sure in which day I will do Banter Blitz, maybe on Monday, maybe on Wednesday. Just follow Chess20 for Twitter, follow my Twitter, friend me on Facebook, follow my YouTube channel, and so on, so on, so on. You won't miss any activity connected with me. Have a nice evening and see you next week. Bye bye.